topic today. It's initiative. This is a fun topic. This is one of my favorite topics. I start off by saying I'm not a scholar, I'm not a sheikh, I'm not a student of knowledge. And by all means, inshallah, if you have any questions, keep it for the people of knowledge, inshallah, especially if there are questions of any Islamic legitimacy. Seek your local sheikh and ask them, inshallah, if you have any questions. Other than that, today I'll be focusing primarily on taking initiative and how it's our responsibility. We kind of start out with this notion, and it's a very dangerous notion, all right? This notion that if you can't see clear results, you should not get involved. I remember we used to, after the war, we would go to protests all the time against the war in Iraq. It was like a big deal. After 9/11, Muslims were being hunted, for lack of a better word. They were being harassed regularly. And so the war in Iraq starts ramping up, and a lot of Muslims go out to protest. And I remember a lot of people had this idea that, what are the protests going to accomplish? What are you going to get from a protest? You're going to go yell and scream at a brick building? It's not going to respond to you. The president isn't going to care. No one cares. You're just going to, what are you getting out of this protest? And there's this very dangerous logic that if I can't see the result in front of me, I should not get involved, or I should not do the action. This is an extremely dangerous opinion. The idea that if I can't see my efforts and the fruition of my efforts, right, if I can't see exactly me stopping the war in Iraq and saving millions and hundreds of thousands and millions of lives, then I should not take an action. This action should not be taken. And I promise you, brothers and sisters, the protests did absolutely nothing. Okay? In terms of actual benefit to stopping the war, it did nothing. The war happened, hundreds of thousands of people's lives were lost, so many people wasted their time. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not require results from us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires effort. This is such a beautiful thing about Islam. Think of your employer. If I went to my employer today, or my former employers, and I had a sales quota, and I didn't meet my sales targets, what happens? They cut me. See you later. Go find a new job. Maybe they'll give me one other chance. I can't go to my employer and say, well, I really tried hard. Employer would just giggle at you and say, get out of my face. I need someone who can give me results. If you're constantly late on your deadlines, your employer would laugh at you and say, get out of here. If you're late on your exam at school, your teacher isn't going to say, okay, I'll just give you another opportunity to take the exam. Teacher's going to say, here's a big fat F. See you later, loser. He won't say that, or he won't say that, but that's the idea. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala works differently, and this is the beauty of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala understands that evil exists, understands that there are challenges in this life, understands that there are things that are working against you, and that your initiative is more important than the results. Which is why the beautiful example, I swear to you, this is one of my favorite verses in the Quran. There are many. But he tells Sidna Maryam, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِدْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقَطْ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Mary alayhi salam, who is literally in labor, who just finished labor, to shake the base of a palm tree. In any scenario, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of examples, this would be an absolutely ridiculous request. To say to someone who is just in labor to shake the base of a palm tree so that dates can come down and feed your child, that's absolutely ridiculous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't expect Sidna Maryam to be able to do that. But it's not about that. It's about the effort. It's about putting in the time and energy to do something, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will meet you the rest of the way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open up doors and give you victory and give you wealth and so many good, and izzah, and honor. But it doesn't just happen because you happen to be Muslim. That doesn't mean anything. It happens because you put in some effort. Even if your effort was lame, even if it was insincere, even if it was full of doubt, nonetheless it's an effort. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will meet you half, the other half, or sometimes the entire way, just because of your small effort. This is a very dangerous theory, the idea that I have to see results.